What was it like to see that process of your book come to life as something new? But
well, she came to me. I can remember. So I live in Sol Soledad, California. She flew up to my house to have lunch with me and says, "I really want.
No worries.
You've changed my life, Dr. Prasad. I can't believe I'm meeting you, Dr. Prasad." And it was very, very nice. She says, "I want to bring it to life to a different public, to a larger public, you know, to the film public, to be able to bring the message about this to the public about how the male and female brain have different hormones and are wired differently, so that we can really appreciate to each other in a different kind of way, and we don't have the same types of arguments anymore." So she said it helped her stop expecting a male to be more like your best girlfriend, which is not going to happen, right? That's definitely not going to happen.
We wish sometimes.
We definitely wish sometimes, but it doesn't work that way. So at any rate, it's been fun to watch it come to life, and kind of the very edgy, funny way and cute way that they brought it out. So I hope you enjoy it.
Yeah,
I know you're going to get to see it in a few minutes, right?
Yes. What do you think is the biggest misconception about males versus females?
I think one of the biggest misconceptions is that we start being formed very differently from the moment the sperm enters the egg, and so that the biggest misconception then at between ages 9 and 15 years old, boys have like a times 250 times the testosterone level. It goes like boom! And so it starts running all those male brain circuits right in your brain. And so I think females don't appreciate that there's this whole other hormone that is running their thinking and running their behavior lots of times. And it's not that they're bad intentioned or anything. It's like this is the way that their brain is thinking because of the hormone testosterone is helping them do that. And we females have our own like cycles up and down, right? Every 28 days we change every week, you know. So I think it helps understand, okay, the person is the good-hearted person that they are, and they have these other things that are kind of driving some of their brain circuits around their hormones. So, and you know, we're wired differently from those tiny testicles that started pumping out all that testosterone right in the beginning. So at any rate, I think that's a big misconception. And once you get that and understand that the male has more aggression and more sex drive, and that's natural, and we shouldn't blame them for it. It doesn't mean society can abandon trying to be civilized, right? But we should give men a little bit more of a break.
Okay.
Right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.